County Traffic Operations Manager, and Wolfgang, Head of Analysis for the Local Metropolitan Planning Organization, are meeting to review the last quarter's performance measurement report to assess progress toward their goals and targets, such as improving travel times and reducing the number of incidents.
Look at this performance measurement report. It's not good. There has been an increase in incidents. And now travel time reliability is a big problem.
That doesn't surprise me. My commute keeps getting worse.
Even on typical weekdays, delays are longer. Travel times are unpredictable. When we have serious problems, delays are staggering.
Like last summer's big pileup in the morning fog?
That's one example. There were two fatalities, and our cleanup wasn't finished for hours. Multiple departments helped, but we weren't well coordinated.
Safety is a top priority for us. And a local professor estimated the loss of productivity was several million dollars for the event, due to congestion. What a nightmare.
Tell me about it. We need to find a new approach to improve travel time reliability. And we need better corridor-wide coordination. I don't want a repeat of last summer's tragedy.
You're right. We need a new approach. And I think I know one we can try. Integrated Corridor Management. ICM, you know that conference I went to last week? It was all about integrated corridor management. I brought back some materials from the Federal Highway Administration. It might be a good approach for us.
What is ICM?
In the traditional approach, different agencies, such as State Highway Agency, local DOT, regional commuter rail, and the local transit agency manage their modes and assets separately. Conversely, ICM is an approach to transportation management, where all existing modes and assets within a corridor work together to manage atypical traffic congestion and give travelers options.
Interesting. Integrated, so it focuses on better coordination. We need that.
And when we think of a corridor, we should consider all the modes travelers can use.
And then, we manage the corridor by flexing all corridor assets to absorb congestion-causing events, rather than only focusing on the small area, or single facility, where an event occurs.
Exactly. The ICM vision is to improve the movement of people and goods during atypical events, using institutional collaboration, technical integration, and proactive implementation of ICM strategies.
ICM strategies, like managed lanes, ramp metering, traveler information, and hot lanes?
Yes, and much more. It's system-wide. ICM envisions managing the corridor as a multimodal system and making operational decisions for the benefit of the whole corridor, not just one facility. And we can study places where ICM has been implemented successfully, like San Diego and Dallas. ICM is being pursued in many other regions, too.
ICM sounds great. Where do we start? Is our area a good candidate for ICM?
I have a checklist of corridor characteristics that indicate where an ICM implementation can be successful. Let me send it to you along with some other ICM materials. We can follow up tomorrow. Hey, Emma.
Hey, I reviewed the ICM checklist, and it lines up with our corridor pretty well.
Great news. I downloaded the list too. Let's read over the attributes. We don't need to match up 10 for 10, but we must have a few critical attributes to build on.
Sure. The first item on the checklist is there significant congestion and unreliability along the travel corridor? The most critical and obvious attribute of a successful ICM deployment is a need.
Is additional infrastructure available within the corridor? Parallel arterials, transit routes, and mode hubs provide alternatives to clogged highways.
Does the area have multimodal capabilities? Bus, rail, transit, and freeway agencies must be able to communicate with each other.
Does the area have a centralized data hub, like a transportation management center? A TMC makes it easier to organize and analyze data.
What procurement practices can we use? We need ITS technology experts who understand the expertise requirements.
Is transit readily available? Bus routes, BRT, HOV lanes, and commuter rail all help relieve a clogged highway.
Are current systems optimized? We should validate that roads cannot be improved by other physical or operational means before implementing ICM.
Are we ready to engage the public and gather feedback? We should be dedicated to transparent and real-time public information and access.
Is there open-mindedness for changes in travel behavior? Educating the public to accept mode and route changes is paramount.
Do we have organizational and institutional support? A strong champion and leadership are vital for laying the foundation for success.
Our corridor seems to check many of these 10 boxes. Now we just need to make it happen.
Right you are, Emma. Let's start with getting the support of management. Let's explain to them the benefits of ICM that make the high degree of operational, technical, and institutional integration required worth it.
Thank you for bringing these attributes of successful ICM to my attention. Hopefully, we can coordinate efforts among our two offices and all the other potential stakeholders once we have the green light to move forward.
Emma and Wolfgang are resolved to implement ICM and improve corridor operations. Check out other segments in our series, as these two ICM champions grapple with the challenges of making their ICM vision a reality in Okanahatchee County.